Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are having a fantastic day. I'm also hoping this microphone's working, hopefully you can hear me. Today's video is going to be a short-range forecast, fuck you, and it will be the next four to five days. We won't be really talking about the long-range much, but we'll be talking about the short-range, so what's going on right now, what to expect, and what, you know, what's going to be going on. So, before we get started, if you'd like to subscribe to this channel, you could do so by clicking that subscribe button. If you'd like to hit the like button on this video after the video is over, you could also do that, you know, telling me whether you like this video or not. And speaking of last video that I made, everybody seemed to really like it. There was a few people that said it was a bit too early, and I agree. I think it's a little bit too early to make a forecast, but that was more like speculation for the fun of it, just to share my thoughts with you guys. So I will be probably maybe making more of those, see, you know, maybe what on fall, what, how about the snowfall amounts in the next coming weeks. But you know, just take it easy, don't get too stressed about it. I think it's not gonna be forecast, it's just showing you what the analogs are showing. So that's about it. So right now, let's look at the GFS model. So this title will probably be something like the cold continues dot 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 not for long or something like that, because as of now you can see we have very chilly conditions, especially across the west, but then we have a storm that moves up, brings slightly warmer conditions across the north central United States. But see, many people are enjoying these conditions right now across the north and the west, because they're cool entering the summer. Even when it's a couple of degrees below average, it's usually around that comfortable range, because if it's above average, then that's usually in the extreme. You know, I mean, there are heat waves, heat advisories right now, as you saw in the National Weather Service map, across heat advisories across many, many states, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, the whole state of Louisiana, almost. I think there's a few counties down to the south that weren't, but I mean, you could see, does it look like a heat wave based on the anomalies? Not at all. It just looks like a little bit above average, but that's enough to bring it up to a heat wave, because it's so warm, the average is, that at this point, anything above average is considered a warm criteria. So you can see it gets a little bit warmer through the next couple of days. Monday being pretty warm for the central, eastern Midwest, and parts of western Northeast. And then we have another lobe of colder air, though, coming, and you can see it gets pretty chilly down here in the mountains in Kansas, quite a bit below average. So I'm expecting 60s and 70s over there. But you can see that they've been having fairly warm temperatures thus far this year, so, or this summer, for the past couple of weeks, so this is definitely not going to do any harm. And you can see this kind of expands for a while and takes over. At least Monday is going to be pretty, chilly, but not cold. But the chilly temperatures continue. You can see now it just starts getting moderate. And these areas, you may be wondering what these are. These are actually thunderstorms. They tap into the very high atmosphere, and the higher you go, usually it is very chilly. You know, several thousand feet above, it could be as cold as negative 40, negative 50 Fahrenheit. And those thunderstorms are capable sometimes of reaching those heights, especially in this area where these storms can grow up to monster sizes. They tap some of that the air, that chilly air, and they bring it down with the downdraft, and that really, really puts the surface temperatures, 2 meter surface temperatures, down, crashing, and that's why those anomalies happen. But you can see otherwise, fairly, I mean, look at this map, it does not really get more equal than this. This is pretty anomaly, you know, free. I mean, there's a lot of white you could see here, so that's basically natural average, not really going either way. There's a little bit towards the west, a little bit warmer and toward cooler, and then towards the east warmer. But then you can see that it seems like the warmer takes over a little bit from north central US, and a little bit chillier across the west and the south possibly. But I'll show you these temperatures. This is going to be pretty hot for these areas, just being that slightly above average. And you can see a little bit of chillier air, but no heat waves at this point, like a major, you know, 100 degree in the areas that typically don't see it. Obviously in the west there's gonna be hundreds, because that's usually, they get pretty warm, and just being a little bit above average gets them there. But we could be going into a warmer pattern. This is a short range forecast, so you know, I'm not gonna show you much more, but I basically already did. But in the 8 to 14 and 6 to 10 day outlooks, they're basically talking about how it's gonna warm up in the east and in the west. So you know, for now, the I don't know how to say this. Most of the country will be chillier or below average. And let's go to the 2 meter temperature shaded. Let's just go out to hour 140 with the short range, because I don't want to go out much further. So you can see it's been pretty chilly. So this was Thursday, for example. You could see I didn't get too warm across these states. 60s 70s, you know, that's not warm, I'm sorry, but that's just chilly, and that's not, you know, no one really likes that, and especially in June when the beaches and pools are open, you no one will want to take a bath in 60 degree weather. And then you could see the storm rises up, so 80s possibly, but look, see how warm it is in Texas down here, and in Florida it's barely above average, but it's hot because that's how close they are to being, you know, in a heat advisory criteria on average in general. So when it's just a little bit above average, doesn't mean that it's, you know, not dangerous. So we see things again starting to warm up, and you could see a lot the 80s, the 70s reaching to the Canadian border. But notice how some of these areas are still going to be holding on to that chilly conditions, but especially the west, that's the only region that's going to be below average. But let's I'll stop at hour 174, but you could see it's going to stay pretty pretty toasty into next week. Will this stay for the rest of summer? I don't know, and most likely not, but we will have to see. Nigger, at least, you know, the average, this is, we're going into the highest time, the hottest time of the year, so when we see, you know, 70s and 60s, that's telling you that it's very below average. And when you're seeing 80s, that not necessarily, oh, that's gonna be a warm summer. It's, it depends. If it's July, August in Chicago, and it's just flat out 80, even 83, that's below average. I know it sounds crazy, but it is. The average is around 87 here, so at that time of the year. So when it are 60s and 70s, and you think that's below average, that's ridiculously below average. That's just not below average. That's record-breaking cold, and we did have some records, I think, broken last week. So these temperatures, say goodbye to them, because 60s and 50s are no more, really, at this point. But the rain is still gonna, you know, be there, but not at such dynamic proportions. So we will just have to see what happens after this time period, even after the 384 time period. It's hard to see what's gonna exactly happen, but doesn't seem like there will be any major heat waves at this point in any giant form. You notice how these little dots during the night, you see those things? That's Indianapolis, that's St. Louis, that is Nashville, I think, or Memphis, no, that, I think that's Nashville. Fucking, that's Atlanta, that's Dallas, those are just cities, and that's an urban heat island effect. That's Chicago, like Minneapolis, Detroit, around every city gets a little bit warmer during the night, because all the heat that was trapped in during the day is being released. And notice how much it's warmer in those areas. It's so fascinating. Look, New York, Washington, D.C. down here, Philadelphia, Hartford, Boston, up there in Maine, the cities are smaller, so they're not as, you know, they're not keeping in so much warmth, but it's just fascinating in my opinion. So I think we're gonna end. Actually, no, I wanted to show you quickly the heat advisory in Texas and Louisiana, and see, you know, show you what's going on. So heat advisory in effect today, you could see 90s, and if you ever were curious what counts as a heat wave, it needs to be 3 days. I think it does depend though on the city, because I know for my location it's 3 days in the 90s or above, and that's considered a heat wave. But if you went to somewhere like Phoenix right here, Arizona area, then 90s are basically like the average, so that wouldn't really be considered a heat wave. I think in the hundreds is considered a heat wave. So yeah, it definitely is depending on the city. I mean, look, 90s every day, but there's no heat advisory, so yeah, okay, I was right. And look at that weather, sunny, mostly clear, sunny, 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 sunny. Seems, you know, look at that, it's getting potentially pretty hot over there, but seems, you know, very, how do I say this, seems very nice and appealing when you first look at it, but trust me, it gets boring and sick quickly. And I could just imagine the crops there, probably, I mean, obviously it's a desert, so only desert things grow there, but holy cow, that's, like, you rarely see that in any part of the state. Just sunny and clear for as far as I could see. Let's go to the city where where it's been pretty rainy. Let's go to Cincinnati area. Let's see what's there in their forecast for the next couple of days. You could see it does seem like a recurring pattern that the next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday for most of the Midwest will be fairly warm. You can see 80s and also fair weather. So all this rain is most likely going to put on a break for at least a while. Not for long, though, obviously. The video is going to pause right now. And we are back. So, yeah, we're back. So I just wanted to quickly, because I was going to end a video earlier, but then I didn't say, you know, goodbye, or my outro, I guess, if you want to call it that. So I just decided to go over the time limit. And there is a severe weather threat going on right now across the country, across Illinois and Missouri, but it's not major. Mostly heavy rain, but definitely some severe thunderstorms are embedded in here. You could see... expect amounts into, okay, so yeah, mainly just severe weather. The rain also pretty heavy though, since they've been seeing quite a bit of rain. So I'll stop blabbling. Consider subscribing, consider liking the video, and if you want to see more of those videos, please let me know. Thank you guys, see you guys in the next episode.